Good evening po sa inyo lahat. Ako po si Christian Esguerra and welcome po sa ating episode ngayong gabi ng ating Facts First Podcast. Today is November 2. I hope nasa mabuti po kayong kalagayan at maraming salamat po sa patuloy niyo pong pagsuporta dito po sa ating programa. Ito po yung paulit-ulit ko po sinasabi sa inyo. So as promised, yesterday I announced po kung sino po yung guest natin for tonight. Pasensya na po, medyo na-delay yung ating programa ngayon dahil nagkaroon po tayo ng konting technical issues and fortunately, thank God, naayos na po siya. Okay? Ang pag-uusapan po natin ngayong gabi, meron po isang viral post yung dating DILG secretary. Kung naalala niyo po po, si Mr. Rafi Alunan. Okay? So meron siyang warning. Sabi niya, we're in a dangerous period and China is bent on going to war. Actually, natanggap ko to a few days ago. I think it was my mother-in-law who sent the screenshot to me. Tapos nakita ko, pinag-uusapan siya online. And I think this is a good opportunity for us to better understand kung ano po yung nangyari dyan sa South China Sea. In particular, dito po sa West Philippine Sea, in the face of China's growing assertiveness, no? Talagang laganap yung pamabuli ng China. And pag-usapan natin kung tama ba at meron bang kulang at kung ano man yung kulang dito po sa response ng kasalukuyang administrasyon dito po sa sitwasyon dito sa West Philippine Sea. So without further ado, I'd like to welcome to our program. I'd like to welcome si former Interior Secretary Rafael Alunan. Magandang gabi, sir, and thank you for joining us dito po sa Facts First.
Magandang gabi sa iyo, Christian. Thank you for inviting me.
Baka manibago kayo kasi the last time we spoke, nasa ANC pa ako, no? And I think
thank you, Christian, for inviting before the
elections. Okay. Sige. Do you hear me clearly, sir? Marino po ba yung dating ko sa inyo?
Choppy. Napuputol. But it's okay now.
Okay. Sige. Pag-usapan natin, no? Ano po ba exactly ibig sabihin nyo rito, no? Because a lot of people were very interested at the very least. And of course, marami na alarm. Nung nag-post kayo sa Facebook at sinabi nyo, we are in a dangerous period and China is bent on going to war. I mean, ano yung basis niyan?
Well, the basis has to do with the analysis of global security analysts. Since 2 years ago, they've been talking about the possibility of China advancing its timeline for war from 2030 to 2027. Mm-hmm. But recently, the global analysts have been talking about as early as 2025. And mm-hmm. the reason for that is because notwithstanding the freedom of navigation operations by the United States and allied nations in the South China Sea, China is becoming more belligerent. Yung bang ang attitude, wala akong pakialam sa ginagawa ninyo. Itutuloy ko yung gusto ko yung mangyari. Tapos, in the case of the Philippines, the coercion and the harassment by the Chinese Coast Guard has been intensifying. Basically, parang goading us into fighting them. Or one can interpret it as saying, goading the United States through the Philippines, no? As using...
Okay, medyo nawawala lang si Secretary Alunan and then hintayin natin, no? Maganda kasi pinag-uusapan natin dito, no? We're very interested also dito sa konteksto na ito. It's not the first time that we heard that China is actually preparing to go to war. Yung binabanggit na timeline na 2027. And it's not the first time that we heard about it. Pero tingnan natin kung meron mo talagang basehan pagdating sa aksyon. And then, you also need to understand na baka naman may mga nagsosow din ng fear regarding this issue. That's why I'm very interested kung ano yung perspective dito ni Secretary Alunan. Intayin siya. Tara, nandiyan na ulit si Secretary Alunan.
Doktor.
Ayan, sir. Okay na. Okay. Sige.
Christian, pasyensya na. Kasi yung connectivity namin dito sa where I am, sa Munting Lupa, it's been very spotty.
Okay lang, sir. Malino kayo ngayon. Malino na.
Okay.
Okay.
Sana ko naputol. At what point?
Hindi, binanggit nyo yung based on analysts. Sinasabi nila na pwedeng advance yung timeline from 2030 to 2027. Tapos sabi niya 2025. Ang tanong ko ganito, no? If it's true that China is bent on going to war over what? Taiwan? or South China Sea or both?
Actually, you have to see it from the standpoint of the geopolitical goal of China, which is to be the next superpower. And the only way for them to be that is to get the United States out of the way in Southeast, in South China, in the South China Sea area. And to be more precise, the Indo-Pacific region. Mm. Nag-umpisa ito yung kanilang belligerence as far back as the 70s when they began gobbling up the islands near Vietnam in the Paracels, no? And then in the 90s, kinuha nila yung Mischief Reef. And then in 2012, they wanted to get Scarborough. Between 2012 to the present, they built three artificial islands that have become military fortresses. And then four other military outposts also in the Spratlys to support those three major fortresses that have missiles, no, to support their air and naval assets in the area. So now you tell me, and anybody will probably, any fellow out there in the street that gets to know this information will probably ask, why is China doing that? Ano bang purpose niya? Hmm. Secondly, dito sa Pilipinas, ang daming mga reports of infiltration of PLA operatives, spies, masquerading as POGO workers, tourists, students. They've been reported by media. Lumalabas yan from time to time. And then in 2020, Senator Lacson and Senator Gordon talked about information that they were receiving that there were at least 3,000 PLA operatives or People's Liberation Army operatives in the Philippines. And when you get to hear also from subdivision owners or residents that there are the Chinese laboratories operating, Shabu laboratories operating there, or Chinese cells that have been broken up because they have high-powered weapons. Recently, last week, it was reported in social media, in this media site called Billionario, that six Chinese nationals were caught with high-powered firearms with two of their security personnel, local security personnel, and with badges that said sniper team, blasting team, machine gun team, etc. So you get to ask yourself, why is this happening? For what purpose? Certainly, there are no good motives here. There's got to be only a bad motive. Now, when I was talking to some people who are still alive, they went through World War II, they said, you know, what's happening today is no different from what we experienced in just before World War II, when the Japanese were infiltrating the Philippines. They were shopkeepers, they were gardeners.
Parang sleeper, no? Parang ganun yung idea. Hello, sir.
Trader.
Medyo spotty lang. Can you hear me, sir? Can you hear me?
Yung pala, they were members of the Japanese intelligence.
Mm. Teka lang, medyo nawawala si Secretary Alunan, no? So, ayan. Balik natin uli siya. Ayan. Ayan, I can hear you now. Ito, sir, yung tanong ko, no? Although, we caught what you were talking about, no? Sabi niya, nakausap niya yung mga buhay pa ng panahon ng Hapon, and then, the situation is basically the same dito sa binabanggit yung infiltration ng ano PLA tsaka Chinese spies, no? Can you hear me, sir? Tayo nating malo mag-improve yung internet connection.
Napuputol ka, Christian. I'm sorry, napuputol ka.
Oo. Eto, sir, malinaw na po ako. Can you hear me?
I don't think you're the problem. I think I'm the problem here. My connectivity is the problem.
Okay,
I'm changing positions. Huh?
Okay. Oh, nagkaroon tayo ng instant house tour nyo. Huh? Nakikita namin yung bahay nyo. Naging instant okay. House tour tuloy. Ito sir, yung gusto ko itanong sa inyo. No? Can you hear me now?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, ito. Pasensya na po, no? Kailangan ko itanong to sa inyo, no? Sa tingin nyo, how much of the situation now with China? Kumbaga, it's growing, it's becoming even more belligerent, no? Mas binubuli yung Pilipinas. At sabi nyo, nagkakaroon ng infiltration ng People's Liberation Army tsaka mga spies masquerading as pogo workers dito sa Pilipinas. Taken together, no? Sa tingin nyo, how much of this situation that we're seeing now is caused by the former administration, by the former president, na talaga naging no, very, very friendly sa China?
No, I don't think so. This has been going on for years. This has been going on for years. We've been very lax. Ang problema sa ating gobyerno, regardless of the administration in charge, we are easily infiltrated because our people are either incompetent or corrupt. Paano nakakapasok itong mga ito? That's handadaan muna. Immigration, di ba?
Hmm.
O tapos sino nag-escort sa kanila? Yung mga police o yung mga ex-military. Walang kinalaman yan sa ano, sa incumbent administration. Ano yan? These guys are mercenaries. They're doing this for money. And there's lack of patriotism there. And on top of that, there is no supervision at all. The gatekeeping is terrible. No, and this is a problem that is experienced by all administrations, including ours during the time with President Ramos. That's why we undertook a house cleaning campaign. But I don't think that was continued on a systematic basis by succeeding administrations. Kaya here we are, no? What I'm trying to say is this. If you read the security papers of the United States, Japan, Australia, Canada, they're very alarmed at the actions of China and in tandem with Russia. No? And then if you get to listen very carefully to President Marcos, Secretary Teodoro, Secretary Ed Anyo, they're quite alarmed. They're raising the alarm about the escalating tensions in the South China Sea. And all of these harassments and coercive behavior of China. And the question now is the leadership harnessing the whole of government to be aligned with that thinking to prepare ourselves better for worst case scenarios that may come our way? Oh, and if the global security analysts are correct that trouble is coming our way in this region, within the next 2 years or so, then what are we doing? What are we doing to protect our populace, our society? Because if we don't make them aware of what's going on, if they're not fed the right information at the right time, they cannot be harnessed for national defense or even for that matter, civil defense. They cannot be a good partner to the government who probably is probably more aware of the situation, but is not unwilling to say so to the public for whatever reason. No?
Okay.
But I've been listening very carefully to what President Bongbong has been saying, Secretary Gilbert and Secretary Ed Anyo, and okay. I hear them. I hear them.
Sige, sir. Pupuntahan natin yung mga ginagawa ng kasalukuyang administration ngayon. No? And then I think you would agree with me na yung environment ngayon under the Bongbong Marcos administration, mas open. Mas marami nakakapagsalita doon sa pambubuling ginagawa ng China. Tama po ba?
That's correct. As a matter of fact, the Coast Guard has applied a very good strategy. And they're fighting information warfare in a better way now than before. They are putting the spotlight under the Chinese, recording okay. every misdeed that they're doing in the South China Sea. And our media here on land, some of them are conscientious enough to report what the Chinese are illegally doing in our country.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's
sir.
Good. That's good.
Oh, nga. Oh, kasi nga, from where I'm sitting, nakikita ko parang nagkakaroon din ng house cleaning ngayon yung Marcos administration. Kasi nga, pasensya na kayo, no? Parang hirap naman pakawalan nung Duterte administration doon sa mga ginawa nila in favor of China. At marami dito sa mga Christian viewers natin hindi ma-accept yung idea na yun. Eh. Kasi nga, he was very friendly to China. He opened the country to China. He allowed POGOs to actually proliferate. And then, parang hirap yata tanggapin para sa marami na...
Well, yeah, I just want to say, please don't apologize to me. Hmm. you have nothing to apologize for to me, because as far as I'm concerned, I'm an ordinary citizen, and I can see exactly what the mistakes were during the Duterte administration, whether it was meant or not meant. The consequences were this, no?
What were these mistakes from your perspective?
Well, yung sinasabing pivoting to China, no? Christian, you must understand how geopolitics is played. And sometimes what the political leaders do or say is not exactly done in a straight line, no? Sometimes they work in crooked lines. And that means playing the game for as long as the purpose is to uphold or protect the national interest. Okay? Indeed. At that particular point in time, there were two... I'm not trying to explain for Duterte. He can explain for himself. But what I'm... This is my discernment. At the time that he took over as president, he had personal issues with the United States. Personal yun. Pero pagdating sa policy, it held, notwithstanding the fact that he was threatening the cancellation of the VFA, eventually binalik niya. And then he invested a lot of money in modernization of the armed forces. Hindi niyo alam siguro, baka you're not privy to mga comments niya na midway through his administration, ang narinig ko from his insiders, cabinet secretaries, he was very much aware that China could not be persuaded to ease up on the Philippines.
Okay. Pero how do you explain yung mga public pronouncements niya na sinasabi niya?
I will not explain for him. He should explain for himself.
Hindi, kasi
I am not his. I was never his advisor, so please don't ask me.
Yes, sir. I know. But someone actually supported him before, no? Don't worry.
No. That I don't like that. Christian, I don't like that assumption. Supported, because I've been attacked by so many people here. Alunan adored this guy that he could do no wrong. I don't like that assumption that I was his supporter in that sense. I supported the policy of protecting the national interest.
Okay.
So that protection included keeping our allies.
Oh.
But nobody asked me then. Everybody was looking at Duterte.
Uh-oh.
But I was on the side of the Lorenzana, where we were sticking to the national interest and making sure that we strengthened our alliances.
Yeah, kasi nga,
so let's keep it that way. Let's keep it in that perspective.
Yeah, I understand. Oh, kasi nung panahon ni President Duterte, I was also in touch with some people from within. Na sinasabi nila, kahit yung mga public pronouncements ni President Duterte, obviously favoring China, merong stability from within the military and from the defense establishment, di ba?
Yeah.
Tama ba?
Christian, can you do me a favor? We're talking about the grand scheme of China here. Let's not focus on the past, okay? Let's focus on the present and on the future, what we can do to defend ourselves against China. Can we do that?
Yeah,
because absolutely. You know, we're doing our audience a disservice by keeping them rooted in the past without looking at the present and working for their future security and safety and survival.
Don't worry, sir. Papunta tayo dyan, no? Kasi nga, hindi naman pwedeng parang bibigyan natin ng free pass, no? Yung nakaraang 6 na taon, no? Kasi nga, honestly,
he did not commit any crime. But by working with China, for example, that was no different from what the Americans were doing. The Americans were in bed with China. They built China to where it was. Mm. Come on. You know, that's geopolitics. And then, who are our top three trading partners? China, United States, and Japan. Mm-hmm. You're going to let go of number two trading partner? What's going to happen to the economy? What's going to happen? It will worsen the poverty in this country. So you have to think of those things about the national interest. You cannot just be one-sided.
No. Don't worry, hindi naman ganoon ka black and white yung perspective ko diyan personally, no. Kanina binabanggit niyo, 'di ba, dun sa post niyo, China is bent on going to war. Yung binabanggit niyo na 'yon, no. Pwedeng ginagamit din siya ng mga propagandists in favor of China, because I'm sure you've heard of this, 'di ba? In the past until now, sinasabi nila, pag nanindigan sa China, gusto ba nating makapagyera sa China. Don't you think yung realidad na sinasabi niyo that China is bent on going to war could actually feed that kind of narrative that we're also seeing now?
I don't get your point. I go along with the saying na I am friends to all right? Enemies, I'm enemy to none, all right? But my friendship, my behavior towards you depends on your behavior towards me. Now, I don't give much credence to what China says. I place my observations on its behavior and the patterns of its behavior. And so far, which we are seeing very clearly, that they cannot be trusted and that things are just worsening, which is why my point is, in writing my columns, is for the government and the media to start providing the citizenry, society, with timely and accurate information so that a whole-of-nation approach could be put in place for the country's national interest through a strategy of security, safety, and survival. No? But nobody is doing that. Everybody's talking about the past. Everybody's talking about small, petty things. No, nobody's looking at the big picture.
Actually, I beg to disagree, Mr. Secretary. No? Pag tinayin niyo ito lahat ng episodes natin dito sa program nito, siguro...
But that's you. That's you, Christian. I'm talking about in general. No? That's you. You in particular. I'm not talking about you in particular. I'm talking about in general.
Marami rin. Actually, marami rin. No? I think it's pretty obvious na under President Marcos, mas malaya magsalita ang lahat, no? Dito sa pambubuli ng China.
No. It's very simple. Right now, have you heard of any strategy or any plan for civil defense in preparation for an oncoming conflict? Meron ba?
Pupuntahan natin yan, sir. Tatanungin ko kayo dyan. Kasi nga, meron din silang national security strategy. And I think this was...
Alam ko yan. I am involved there. Walang problem. But that's not the point. The point is, is... what is actually happening on the ground? Is there civil defense discussions taking place?
Oh, sige, sir.
Diba? Is media being mobilized to come up with a reportage that will generate or improve the awareness of our people about the threat to their future? Meron bang ganun? Na concerted effort, kasi
wala bang
as you know, China is involved also in information warfare, and psychological warfare is part of it. Influence operations is part of it. Are we looking into that? Are we looking into influence operations as far as our national government officials are concerned, local government officials, our NGOs, our media? Is anybody looking into that? Malalim ang problema natin.
We are, sir, actually. Sige, isa-isahin natin yan. Again, I know you're not referring to me in particular, pero I think it's safe to say na I and many other people in media, pati naman yung National Security Council ngayon, no? Yung NSA, they're even talking about yung influence operations ng China. Dito sa programa na to, repeatedly, binabanata natin yung mga Pilipino na talagang propagandist in China, pati yung mga so-called think tank, no? And I think there's a growing awareness now. But I understand where you're coming from, no? Kailangan ng mas concerted effort. So bago natin i-detalye yung mga kailangan, no? I think this is also a very important issue to talk about. Let's talk about how difficult the situation now of the Marcos administration in terms of dealing with all these things. Ang daming sanga-sanga, di ba?
That's correct. They inherited a very big problem. Long ago, previous administration should have continued the process of cleansing the bureaucracy. Kasi, you know, you may come up with the best policies, but if you don't have an army of implementers, which is your bureaucracy, nothing's going to happen to you. Your policies and your programs will just fall by the wayside, or it will just gather dust in the shelf after the plans come out. It will just gather dust. Nobody's going to read it. Nobody cares. Has anybody done anything about reinventing government or reinventing the bureaucracy? We're suffering the consequences of that now. You talk to an ordinary bureaucrat. You talk to them about this problem with China. They'll probably give you a blank stare.
So what should be done? Sige. This is the opportunity to talk about this. For example, as dito sa level ng LGUs, local government units. To be fair to you, sir, no, I think it's sa inyo ko talaga nadidinig to, no, the importance of LGUs as frontliners dito sa laban na ito, no. What exactly do you want them to do?
Well, it's not what they want. You know, if I have to tell them what to do in these times, they're the wrong guys. They should know better. I mean,
but someone should tell them.
We're talking about the defense of the country. The defense of their communities, of their local government units. If they're not aware of that, they're in the wrong place. Now, what I would do, having been a national government official, I would gather the League of Governors, the League of Mayors, Barangay League, all of these aggregations, no, that pertain to local governance, and have a summit. Have a summit on national security together with the Office of the National Security Advisor, the Secretary of National Defense, the Department of Foreign Affairs Secretary, and the DOTR Secretary that's in charge of the Coast Guard, under the auspices of the National Security Council held by the President. That is what you call harnessing whole of government. Okay. Because these are the leaders elected and appointed. So that is my advice to, if I were to be asked by the leadership, that would be my advice. Summit. And then, National Security Summit, but it will have to be held behind closed doors. Okay. And then at the same time, harness LEDAC, the Legislative Executive Development Council, to look at all of the laws and rules and regulations that need to be amended, that need to be passed or need to be junked, to make sure that they're supportive of policies that will ensure our safety, security, and survival during wartime. Because war is coming, whether we like it or not. It's already in Europe. It's spreading to the Middle East. It's coming to the Indo-Pacific theater. And look at all the protagonists. It's the same protagonists.
Okay. Eto, let's be more specific, no? How should we address ito infiltration ng People's Liberation Army nitong mga spies through POGO na sinasabi niyo?
Kausapin ng DOJ, because DOJ is in control of immigration. And then dapat yung DFA should be involved because they're in touch with through the ambassadors, they're in touch with the governments that are involved here. Not only China, where the POGOs are coming from, which is actually banned by China, but also those other countries where money is being laundered by the POGOs. You know, dapat i-meet nila ito and come up with a common strategy.
Pero because, okay po kayo to keep the POGOs?
Again?
Okay kayo to keep the POGOs here?
Of course not. If they're the source, they could be a source of funding insurgency and subversion here. Number two, they could be a haven for infiltrators, for moles, sleeper cells. Of course not.
And maraming crime related, no, coming from Pogos. Okay, yeah, number two, let's talk about specifics, no? Influence operations. How should we deal with that? Naghanap yan, no? May mga so-called analysts, no? Nadidinig
well,
natin yan.
This is where the intelligence community comes in. They have to be on their toes, especially counterintelligence, because these infiltration and influence operations have been happening for some time, and I'm sure there are already people that are embedded in strategic institutions, including corporations that are managing strategic infrastructure. All of these things have to be looked into, and this is where the entire intelligence community must come in, but aided by patriotic people in government, in corporations, etc. They cannot just do this on their own. This has to be a partnership between the public and the government officials.
Okay. Sige. Maraming salamat po, former DALG Secretary Rafi Alunan, for joining us tonight. Salamat sa pagsagot po ng mga tanong natin, no? Sana hindi naman kayo na-high blood, no? akala ko na-high blood na kayo kanina, eh.
Hindi, kanina na-high blood ako dahil sa ang sama ng connectivity.
Okay.
Sige, napuputo lagi at pati yung aking train of thought nasisira.
Okay. Sige, sir. Maraming salamat po at magandang gabi sa inyo.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Good night. Thank you.
Oh, anong tingin nyo? You be the judge. teka lang. Ayusin lang natin itong ating cargen. Yan. Okay. Nababasa ko yung mga comments nyo, no? Okay. Nababasa ko yung mga comments nyo, don't worry. And I agree with many of them, no? Although, buhay na buhay mga trolls ngayon, ha? Baka nahihirapan na kayong mag-analyze, no? Pag sinasabi niya na anti-bongbong ako, pinupuri ko nga yung niya, yung mga ginagawa niya in dealing with China, with China's assertiveness, yung pambubuli ng China sa West Philippine Sea, no? Pero yun nga, ang hirap tanggapin kasi noon, no? Yung parabang, we will just talk about this issue as it is now, tapos hindi natin babalikan kung paano tayo umabot sa ganito kalaking problema. Dahil a big part of that had to do with what the previous administration did or did not do. Ang hirap naman yata tanggapin noon. Move on na lang. Tapos hanggang ngayon, yung mga supporters nila, pati yung mga kung sino-sino mga taong supporters nila, no? Ayoko nang banggitin yung mga terms, no? Hanggang ngayon, talaga nag-aasik ng lagim in terms of somehow justifying the unjustifiable. Hindi pwedeng ganon, no? Kaya nga, di ba, kung napapansin niyo yung linya ng pagtatanong ko dyan, gano'ng kabigat yung problema ngayon na inabutan ni President Bongbong Marcos. Hindi pwedeng bigla na lang sumulpot chat at isisisi. Totoo rin naman yun, no? Hindi naman nangyari lang yan, lahat yan over the past 6 years, no? Talagang marami dyan, nagsimula pa dati. Pero syempre, I think, ang dami nangyari or nag-worsen under the past 6 years. Hindi tayo pwedeng manahimik at pumikit lang doon. Diba? Ang dami-daming sinabi noon. Hanggang ngayon, diba recently, pinupuri pa rin ni dating Pangulong Duterte si Xi Jinping, napakabait daw, diba? Tapos ang dami niya sinasabi na sa inyo na yung tubig, sa amin yung isda. Oh. Ang dami mga ganun pronouncements na hinahanapan mo ng sophistication, pero pag in-analyze mo, hindi naman tayo nagagaling-galingan tulad ng sinasabi rito ng isang troll, no? Pero hindi naman tayo bobo, no? May konting alam naman tayo dito sa pinag-uusapan natin, no? So, actually, nung simula nung Duterte administration, pag nakakausap ko yung mga malapit sa kanya, ito yung mga analyst, no? Yung talagang sinasabi ko, baka naman may sophistication behind the crass words or the very public pronouncements favoring China by the president then, no? Pero pag inanalyze mo, parang wala eh, no? Parang talagang gusto lang kampihan yung China eh. Yung pogo na yan, saan ba nag-worsen yan? Di ba during the past 6 years? Tapos, ito naman, di ba? Ang daming bigilang tumatapa ngayon. Napapansin nyo, di ba? May mga senador, may mga house members. Oh. Let's face it. Yung mga dating nagtrabaho sa Duterte administration, ngayon biglang tumapang. Biglang nagsasalita against China, dun sa pambubuli ng China, na hindi natin nadidinig sa kanila during the time of President Duterte. Ang tanong, hindi ba sila makapagsalita noon dahil wala sila nakitang mali dun sa ginagawa ng China at ginagawa ng administration noon? O baka naman dahil ang environment during that previous administration, very restrictive. Kapag nagsalita ka against China, eh baka mayari ka. Eh ngayon, yung tone from the top, yung mensahe galing sa Pangulo, again ha, pinupuri natin si President Marcos, napakalinaw, di ba? Hindi nagpapabuli. Minomobilize yung resources natin. Walang sinasabing mga, so far, no, President Marcos has been saying all the right things in terms of dealing with China and backing it up with good action. Oh, yun ang reason kung bakit itong mga dating supporter ni President Duterte nakakapagsalita na ngayon. Ang pinagkaiba, nag-iba yung presidente. Di ba? Hindi naman rocket science yan. Malinaw ba? Ayan. Sige. Okay na. Kayo naman, nakahigh blood agad kayo eh. Nagkikwentuhan lang naman kami. Huwag naman ganun. Okay, may babatiilan tayo, no? Nga pala, doon sa mga nagpadala ng video, doon sa ating Facts Natics Unite episode for tomorrow, di ba, ang tanong natin doon is, dapat na mapapasukin ni BBM, ang ICC. May mga nagpadala na, pwede po po kayo magpadala, no? Hanggang bukas ng umaga, intayin po natin. Up to 1 minute yung video, isend nyo lang po sa aking Facebook page, no? Doon sa message. Okay? Batingin lang natin ito. Shout out kay Divine Villafuerte. Nag-message siya, kailan ba? Kahapon, pasensya na, late ko nabasa. Sabi niya, pabati naman yung friend niya. It's her birthday today. Ang pangalan, si Maria Luz Remejio. Belated happy birthday po sa inyo. Si Miss Luz Remejio. Ayan. Tapos yung mga nagpapa-shoutout kanina, si Rudy Villacruzis. Shoutout from San Francisco, California. Si Ronnie Bebit from... Quincy, Massachusetts. Watching your program every day, very informative. Maraming salamat. At least may napulot naman kayo, no? Totoo naman sabi ko kanina, 'di ba? Ilan lang ba 'yun talaga ilang programa lang ba 'yung na-encounter niyo na talagang pinag-uusapan itong mga propagandista ng China, itong mga influence operations na ginagawa ng China. O, hindi naman napapanood ba 'yun sa mainstream media? Bihirang bihira, 'di ba? Shout out din kay Nathaniel, Mangune, watching from Bahrain. Ayan, tapos, ito si Giovanni Dunton or Dunton. Pabati po kay Mr. and Mrs. Dan and Tina Lutino. Wow, newlyweds. Best wishes po sa kanila watching here from Montalban, Rizal. Wow, congratulations kay Dan and Tina Lutino. Naway maging maligaya ang inyong pagsasama. Ayan. Sabi ni Romulo Lorica, naggaling-galingan ka, Esguerra, sa banda. Okay. Paki-specify nga para masagot ko naman yung sinasabi mo. Baka hindi mo lang naintindihan yung pinag-uusapan, kaya humirik ka lang ganyan, no? Specify mo nga, ano ba rin sa pinag-usapan namin? Yung ano ba, yung geopolitics, yung friends to all, enemies to none concept? Gusto ba ipaliwanag ko sa iyo yun? Oh, yung sinasabi na ano, yung konsepto ng nakara-administrasyon yan, di ba? Tsaka equidistance daw, no? Parang ginagamit lang yan para i-justify yung mga kung ano ng mga pro-China movements nila, eh, no? Okay, ayan. Romulo, basa-basa ka ng background bago ko humirit, okay? Para hindi syunga yung mga comment na ganyan. Sino pa ba? Ano to? Nanggigigil ako kay Romulo kanina. Sino bang Romulo yung pinanggigigil? Ah, yung ano yung nag-comment. Okay. Sabi ni... Teka lang, nasa ba to? Babasahin yung comment ni Kerr. Shoutout po dun sa nag-iwan ng kalamay sa sementeryo kahapon. Matabang po, kulang sa asukal. Kinain mo naman. Nagets ko yun, ha? Ayan. Icebreaker lang daw. Pero mukhang totoo, ha? Napaka-specific na sinabi mo, ha? Ayan. Ayan. Grabe ka naman, Rob C. Okay lang yan. Mm-mm. Sino pa ba? Hindi mo tayo nagagaling-galingan. Ipapaliwanag lang tayo ng ano, ng konting nalalaman natin. Ayan. Okay, sige, tama na. Gabi na. Oh. Okay. Hoika, Fox First from Norway. Hoika, saan ka sa Norway? Maganda dyan ah. Tsaka mahal dyan ah. Hmm? Ganda dyan sa Tromso, no? Napunta ako dyan before. Tromso, Norway. Ang ganda-ganda. Doon ko nakakita yung Northern Lights. Yabang eh, no? Humirit pa ng ganun eh, no? Wala, nag-share lang ako. Hindi naman tayo, ano? Ayan. Eric Art, Pagalawin ang baso. Baka nagpalit ang pangalan kayo talaga. O ano, namimiss ko na si Eric Art. Nasaan na ba siya? Yan ang paborito nating loyalista eh. Oh, kayo mga pinklawan, ang negaraw ng vibes na iniimit nyo. Oh, kasi dapat unity na lang. Puro kayo paninira, ano. Diba? Okay, yung ganun. Okay na. Sige na, gabi na. Okay, sige. Maraming salamat. Oh, may nanonood from Israel. Oh, si Peter Dughon. Ayan, sino pa ba to? Sino ba to? Good night, sir. Bukas ulit sana si sir na naman ang guest mo para masaya at may matutunan tayo. Sino na naman? Si Llamas. Ba't ba gustong-gusto nyo yun? Eh, wala tayo napupurado ni eh. Diyos ko po. Diba? Parang ano lang eh. Parang kwentuhan lang sa barberie eh. No? Eh, natin papatulan yan si Llamas na yan. Diba? Okay. O sige, ito. Seryoso na to. No? Magandang gabi sa inyo lahat and kita-kita po tayo bukas. Tomorrow is Friday. Dito po sa Fox First. Again, maraming salamat po sa Team Replay. I hope you enjoyed this program. At higit sa lahat, higit sa enjoyment, dapat marami po tayo lahat natutunan. At mas naging matinding resolve natin para piliin at gawin ang tama. At hindi po i-tolerate yung mali. Okay? Magandang gabi po sa inyo lahat.